सर गुड मॉर्निंग। केमिस्ट्री सेकेंड ईयर इंग्लिश मीडियम यूनिट इज सरफेस केमिस्ट्री। टॉपिक इज कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ एंजाइम कैटालिसिस। कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ एंजाइम कैटालिसिस। ऑलरेडी इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस द एंजाइम कैटालिसिस। सो व्हाट आर द बायोकेमिकल रिएक्शंस आर डिस्कस्ड। Then, yes, while discussing biochemical reactions or enzyme catalysis, yes, enzymes are biocatalysts. Enzymes are biochemical catalysts which are highly effective. That is mentioned. Then, so let's see the characteristics of enzyme catalysis. Yes, enzyme catalysis is unique in its high efficiency and high specificity. Already discussed in the previous class. Yes, enzyme catalysis is highly efficient. High efficient and high specific. Yes, how it is, let's see. Then it's a most highly efficient. Why enzyme catalytic reactions? Why the enzymatic reactions or enzyme catalytic reactions are more efficient is then so one molecule of an enzyme, may transform 1,000,000 molecules of the reactants per minute. Yes, that's why yes, enzymatic reactions are more efficient. Here is what one molecule of enzyme can transform one million molecules of reactants to yes, here is a products per minute. One molecule of enzyme can transform 1,000,000 reactant molecules to products per minute. That's why yes, these are more efficient. Then so due to this reason, a very little quantity of catalyst is sufficient. That's why yes, the enzymes are in general secreted in living beings very small quantities because just these are highly efficient. Then next one is highly specific in nature. So enzyme catalytic reactions are specific, highly specific in nature. Why? Then yes, here is each enzyme is specific for a given reaction. That is, one catalyst catalyzes only one reaction. It's a example, urease catalyzes the hydrolysis of urea only. Okay, yes, here is enzymes are highly specific. Enzyme catalyzed reactions are more specific. Reason is what? An enzyme can catalyze the only for a reaction only. That is, one catalyst catalyzes only one reaction. Yes, suppose if we take the urease enzyme catalyzes the hydrolysis of urea only. So it cannot hydrolyze another amides. That's why these are more specific. Catalytic reactions are more specific. Then every enzyme has its own activity for a single reaction. Then next one is highly active under optimum temperature. These enzyme catalyzed reactions are having optimum temperature. That means what? The rate of an enzyme catalyzed reaction is maximum at a definite temperature. That temperature is called as optimum temperature. Then so in general, the optimum temperature for enzyme catalyzed reactions is 298 to 310 kelvins. So human body temperature being 310 kelvins is suited for enzyme catalyzed reactions. Okay, then under optimum temperature, under optimum temperature, the enzyme catalyzed reactions rate is maximum. That's why, so these are highly active under optimum temperature. So why do we, how can you define here is the optimum temperature? Is the temperature at which the rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction is maximum, that temperature is called as optimum temperature. Then so in general, the optimum temperature for enzyme catalyzed reactions is what? Is a 298 to 310 kelvins. That is nearly, here is a 25 degree centigrade to then is a 37 degree centigrade. So that's why is a human body temperature being 310 kelvins is suited for more enzyme catalyzed reactions. 37 degrees or 310 kelvins human body temperature is a optimum temperature for enzyme catalyzed reactions. At is a 310 kelvin, yes, here is a enzyme catalyzed reactions are maximum in human body. Then yes, let's see the another one is highly active under optimum pH. Yes, so in order to get the more rate of enzymatic reactions or enzyme catalyzed reactions, then optimum temperature, a specific temperature is also required. Yes, optimum pH means what? Yes, optimum pH is then, yes, the pH at which the rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction is maximum, that pH is called as optimum pH. Yes, what is the optimum pH for enzyme catalyzed reactions? Is in general here is a 5 to 7. That is what 5 to 7 means what? In general here is a weak acidic character to here is a neutral. So in pH scale from 5 to 7 is a weak acids to here is a neutral state. 7 is a neutral state. Okay, then strong acidic conditions, then next one strong basic conditions are not useful for enzyme catalyzed reactions. Okay, that's why yes, here is a pH 5 to 7 is a optimum pH for enzyme catalyzed reactions. That's why yes, in general in human body, so the blood pH is nearly 7.2. That indicates what? It is a neutral. Okay, then so gastric juices also here is what? Acidic. Gastric juices also acidic, but the acidic condition must be here is what? Weak acidic condition. The strong acidic conditions are not suitable for enzyme catalyzed reactions. Then next one, increasing activity in presence of activators and coenzymes. Then another characteristic of enzyme catalyzed reactions is then yes, in presence of activators and coenzymes. In presence of activators and coenzymes, the enzyme catalyzed reaction rate of reaction is maximum. So what are the coenzymes? Coenzymes means what? Enzyme is nothing but a protein molecule. Okay, this protein molecule is associated with a non-protein. It's a non-protein, yes, a substance, then that is called as here is a coenzyme. Okay, in presence of coenzymes, then the enzyme catalyzed reactions rate is maximum. The enzyme catalyzed reactions rate is maximum. Is a non-protein part plus enzyme, yes, is concerned as here is coenzyme. Then yes, next one is activators. Is a what are the activators? Yes, in presence of activators, the rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction is maximum. Yes, is in general the activators are metal ions. metal ions. Generally, yes, a sodium ions. Then next one is a manganese, Mn plus 2 ions, CO plus 2 ions, Cu plus 2 ions, and potassium ions. Okay, so these are metal ions influence the rate of enzyme catalyzed reactions. Suppose if any enzyme is less active in presence of metal ions, their activity can be enhanced. Then yes, next is a best example for here is a amylase enzyme. Amylase enzyme in general involved in the is a metabolism of a carbohydrates. Okay, then in order to activate the amylase enzyme, here is a sodium ions. Sodium ions are, yes, act as activators. Then is a calcium ions. Calcium ions also is what they can act as a, here is a activators. In general in blood clotting, then is a prothrombin. Prothrombin is converted into, here is a thrombin. Then this is happened in presence of a calcium ions. Okay, so these biochemical reactions are activated by some metal ions. Then next one is influence of a inhibitors and poisons. Then the rate of acid, the rate of enzyme catalyzed reactions, influenced by, here is a poisons and inhibitors. Yes, so in general catalyst also having the, there is a effect by the inhibitors and the poisons. The same way enzymes also influenced by the inhibitors and the poisons. How then? In general, the enzymes are colloidal, is a particles, colloidal particles which are having the, here is a active functional groups over the surface of is a enzyme molecule. When these active functional groups are affected, the active functional groups are blocked by the inhibitors, or poisons, then what happens? Yes, their activity, yes, enzymes activity can be suppressed, or in sometimes the activity of enzymes can be destroyed. Okay, so this is happened, yes, by means of inhibitors and poisons. Then yes, in general, yes, drug action is simply, here is a related to the, yes, related to the this kind of behavior. Okay, it's a some of the drugs are act as inhibitors. Okay, so they can interact with the active sites of enzymes. As a result of that, the active sites of enzymes can be blocked, then the biochemical reaction can be inhibited, the biochemical reaction can be stopped. Okay, so these are the characteristics of enzyme catalysis. The first one, if the first characteristic of enzyme catalysis is most highly efficient. In general, the enzyme catalyzed reactions are more efficient because just one molecule of enzyme can, yes, convert the one million molecules of reactants to products per minute. That's why they are more efficient than, so more specific. Yes, every enzyme has its own action. Then next one is highly active under optimum temperature. At a specific temperature, the enzyme as a catalytic activity is very, very high. Okay, then next one is, there is active under optimum pH. At a specific pH, the rate of enzyme catalyzed reaction is maximum. Yes, so the optimum pH for enzyme catalyzed reactions is 5 to 7. Then next one, there is activators and coenzymes also influence the rate of reaction of enzyme catalyzed reactions. Then, so in general, the activators in general are metal ions. Then here is a coenzymes. Coenzyme is nothing but what? The enzyme associated with a non-protein part, then that is called as a coenzyme. So coenzyme also act as here is activate. Coenzyme also enhance the rate of reaction. Then it's a influence of inhibitors and poisons. Okay, it's a in general there is a in general catalyst also having the is a effect of inhibitors and poisons. Then yes, here is the enzymes also having the enzymes also influenced by the inhibitors and the poisons. Yes, when the active sites of enzymes are blocked by the inhibitors or poisons, there is the activity is suppressed. Okay, so this is enough for yes characteristics of enzyme catalysis.